praying for gathering together in the sight of God to witness and to bless the joining together of Jeffrey Dean Hovis and Sarah Frances Rubisol in Christian marriage. The covenant of marriage was established by God, who created us male and female for each other. With his presence and his power, Jesus graced the wedding at Cana of Galilee, and in his sacrificial love, gave us the example for the love of husband and wife. Jeff and Sarah come to give themselves to one another in this holy covenant. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
Presence of God and these people to declare your intention to enter into union with one another through the grace of Jesus Christ, who has called you into union with himself through baptism. Sarah, will you have Jeff to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Jeff, will you have Sarah to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Let us pray. God of all peoples, you are the true light illuminating everyone. You show us the way, the truth, and the life. You love us even when we are disobedient. You sustain us with your Holy Spirit. We rejoice in your love in the midst of our lives. We praise you for your presence with us, and especially in this act of solemn covenant. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. The scripture reading comes from Colossians, from the Message translation. Hear the word of God as recorded by the Apostle Paul. So chosen by God for the new life of love, dress in the wardrobe of God picked out for you, compassion, kindness, humility, quiet strength, and discipline. Be even-tempered, content with second place, and forgive an offense. Forgive as quickly and completely as the Master forgave you. And regardless of what else you put on, wear love. It's your basic, all-purpose garment. Never be without it. Let the peace of Christ keep you in tune with each other, in step with each other. None of this going off and doing your own thing. And cultivate thankfulness. Let the word of Christ, the message, have the run of your house. Give it plenty of room in your lives. Instruct and direct one another using good common sense. And sing. Sing your hearts out to God. Let every detail in your lives, words, actions, whatever, be done in the name of the Master Jesus, thanking God the Father every step of the way. Here ends the reading of the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Here today. I am so excited for Jeff and for Sarah, for the love that they share, and that they are building this marriage upon the foundation of Christ and upon the church. Every time I have the privilege of officiating at a wedding, I reflect on how profound and how far-reaching are the vows that are made before God and before all these witnesses. You are promising that you will have and hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until you're separated by death. You know, that's a long time. That's a long, long time. A lot of life will come between those words, a lot of gaps, a lot of spaces, a lot of toothpaste caps not put back on like they should, a lot of dishes left in the sink, or so I'm told. Don't ask my wife. A lot of going in circles, refusing to stop and ask for directions. A lot of miscommunication, like ships that pass in the night. Someone may believe that the first major purchase you should make will be a boat. Someone else may think that the first major purchase should be a house. All of these aspects of life will be lived out between these words, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until you're parted by death. Paul wrote to the church in Colossae, so chosen by God for this new life of love, dressed in the wardrobe that God picked out for you, compassion, kindness, humility, quiet strength, discipline. Be even-tempered, content with second place, quick to give, quick to forgive, quick to forgive. Forgive as quickly and completely as the Master forgave you. And regardless of what else you put on, wear love. It's your basic, all-purpose garment. Never be without it. Sometimes I think it's difficult for people to hear preachers talk about love because it's so far removed sometimes from the world that they see when they go home and they turn on the news at night. We have a world that we live in that's full of wars, a world that we live in that's full of tragedy. But of course, if you think about it, our world is really no different than the world of the Apostle Paul. That was a world full of tragedy. That was a world full of wars. That was a world full of violence. And Paul wrote to the believers at Colossae to be radically different from the world. Paul said, you are to be radically different from the world. In Alan Paton's novel, Pride, the Beloved Country, the character Isamandu states, the tragedy is that things are not broken. The tragedy is that they're not mended again. It never ceases to amaze me that when God decided to mend the brokenness and the tragedy of this world, that God did not send down legions of armies to overthrow the Romans, but what God sent down was a baby. Very special baby. God sent down the most precious baby of all, his only son. And this baby grew to be a man. He taught us the depth and the dimension of love. Depth and dimension of love through kenosis, through emptying oneself out for others. That kind of love that emptied itself out on a cross. This is the radical nature of love. So know that as we gather here on this reverential occasion, on this so special and blessed day, know that our hearts are filled with joy. We pray God's blessing upon your marriage, that you will grow deeper in your walk with Christ, that your marriage will forever be bound together by God's steadfast love and by his example of sacrifice. For it takes a lot of sacrifice on both parts to make a marriage strong. We ask all of this for you and so much more We pray God's blessing upon you and God's love shower down upon you. We pray all of this in the name of the Father and of the Son.